I did a video. I did a meme on this on the Disenthrall Facebook page a while back, but I think it's worth talking about more. The headline is this: law enforcement took more stuff from people than burglars did last year. And they have a graph.
Sweet.
To go with it. Asset forfeitures surpass burglaries. Can you guys see this? Let's see. Make sure it's centered here. Yeah, look at this graph. And it's got burglary going down. Like, since since 2010, actual burglary is on the down. police burglary is on a... It's a sharp increase going on here. It is moving towards the parabolic graph shape at this point. Of course, they don't call it police burglary. They call it asset forfeiture and taking...
Oh, yes, I forfeited my assets, yeah.
Yeah, law enforcement took more stuff. They didn't steal more stuff like the burglars steal, right? Anyway, so the graph made me chuckle because it's the typical statist obfuscation of language. You know, they're using special words for the different people doing the exact same activity, stealing. One's a burglar, the other one's a police officer. One is theft, the other one is asset forfeiture. It's like these are all euphemistic bullshit names for stealing, for theft. Theft by force. And so I tried to help them out a little bit. I tried to fix their meme for them. The headline should have been burglaries double under police protection, because this is like a thing that most people don't get. Like, when you argue with a statist, they're like, well, we need the police for protection. Without the cops, you know, who's going to protect us? We need protection. Save us. Safety, 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 whatever. Well, guess what? Burglaries just doubled under your police protection. And I think that's an important thing that more of us should be pointing out to people. Like, we are under police protection and they are utterly failing. In fact, they are more than half of the criminals, at least in this category. They are now more than half of the criminal activity going on. So it's good to remember that. What do you think?
Yeah, totally. The obfuscation of language, euphemism. And it's funny too that forfeiture is a word that actually puts the action on the person being stolen from. Like, we're not taking from you. You forfeited.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because you broke the law. Like, that's some elementary school teacher shit. Like, you know, you forfeited your recess privileges means you chose to give them up because you did something wrong. What's actually going on is people are losing money because it's being stolen from them.
It's such an inversion of reality. Like, another story kind of along with the same kind of inversion that I saw recently was somebody told me about a story where a mother was forced to sign a consent form. Did you hear the words that I just put in that order? Forced by a judge to sign a consent form allowing a doctor to vaccinate her son. It was like a custody dispute or something like that. And the mom didn't want the kid vaccinated and the dad did. So it went into court. And then the judge basically sided with the father and forced the mother, on pain of, you know, I'm sure penalty, you know, contempt of court, jail, whatever the punishment would have been, to sign a consent form. And the story was basically this woman was basically crying while signing this consent form. Oh, you saw, you know the story. Okay.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Let me know if I got any part of that wrong.
But no, that sounds like what I read. Yeah. What I saw.
The fucking absurdity of ordering somebody to sign a consent form on pain of attack or imprisonment or whatever. Like, if you're, I feel like I'm stating the dumb obvious right now, but like most of the world's population that doesn't get this. If you're forcing somebody to sign something, it isn't consent. Like, there's no consent at play if someone is crying, reluctantly signing a consent form. That's not consent. Just go vaccinate the kid and leave her alone. Like, your paper saying that she consented is meaningless. Even using your own law, like legal rules, a contract signed under duress is not valid. Well, you just made her under duress sign a consent contract. It's not valid even under your own rules. Just absurd. But it's same kind of,
it's
like
so
the inversion.
Slimy, man.
Yeah.
It's so slimy. And George Orwell, I forget the exact quote, but in 1984, talking about newspeak, talks about how language is actually one of the most powerful things, if not the most powerful thing, to limit people's actual scope of thought. So it's not that you disagree with what the states do. It's not that most people disagree with what the state is doing anymore. It's they can't even understand, because of the limitations of the language that's been foisted upon the thing, that it's wrong. It's like, oh, it's not burglary, it's forfeiture. Oh, she signed a consent form. But look at the reality of what it is. You know, what makes it slimy is even the people in government know what they're doing is despicable. So they have to euphemize it. You know, they can't come out and say, yeah, we're robbing people more than fucking ever. We're beating the non-police burglars this year.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I saw that lady. Yeah, crying. Yeah, that's really consensual. It reminds me of the, who was it? It was years ago that they said the income tax is voluntary. One of these guys in some Congress, some hearing, this
I get told senator that all the time.
Congressman said, and we... Oh, we really? Have this rich tradition of our voluntary, our income tax that's paid voluntarily. Really?
That is so out of touch with reality. Like, what world is he
in? Well, it really, language really, it really shapes reality. And a lot of people think that's a hippie, woozy, floozy stuff. But actually, when you limit people's, you know, range of concept and thought, you know, you have something like taxation, which... an alien would come to Earth and see it obviously as a threat of force and taking something. Whereas most people that you talk to now will say, oh, but that's not stealing. That's not extortion. That's taxes. So the word to them becomes this authority, and it actually obfuscates the reality of the situation.
Do you know who that consent form was for? I just kind of realized this. The consent form was to make the doctor feel okay about doing it. That's who it was for, because the doctor, you know, violated the consent of one of the parents of that kid. But having that paper, you know, probably helped his conscience, you know, probably made it okay for him to do it. Maybe a legal liability for him too. But yeah, that's crap. That is crap.
Yeah. It's like, you know, he got God's signature, you know, he got the state's signature, part of the cult. It's okay.
Yep.
Insane, man.